Using black holes to get from one place to another is an interesting story. Here, people sometimes talk about wormholes. Wormholes, or shortcuts through space-time, were first considered because they arise as solutions to some of the equations of Einstein's general theory of relativity. Unfortunately, the first such solutions were such that if you tried to travel through one of them, it would immediately collapse and crush you, that is, having you in it would prevent the wormhole solution from working. In the mid-1980s, interest in wormholes that could be traversed was rekindled because Carl Sagan wrote a novel, Contact. Perhaps you've seen the movie? In which he needed a wormhole that could be traveled safely. Given that he was a famous scientist, he didn't want to just babble meaningless technojargon, so he called up his friend Kip Thorne, a professor at Caltech who is an expert in general relativity. Thorne and his colleagues have since worked out some solutions of the equations which may allow for wormholes that can be traveled through safely. The only catch is that they have to be made of so-called exotic matter, which has a total energy which is negative. This isn't quite as impossible as it sounds, but it still isn't all that likely. By the way, one tricky thing about wormholes, and about faster than light travel in general, is that any time you can appear to go faster than light, you can travel backwards in time. This is one consequence of Einstein's theory of relativity. Therefore, if you have a wormhole you can time travel. This can lead to lots of nasty paradoxes. One of the most common is called the grandfather paradox. In this paradox, we suppose that I am a brilliant scientist but a real scumbag of a person. I invent a time machine, and my use for it is to go back in time and kill my grandfather before he met my grandmother. Since he's dead, he can't produce my father, who can't produce me, which means that I could not have built the time machine and killed my grandfather, which means that he was able to meet my grandmother and produce my father, then me, so I was able to make the time machine and kill him, so. You get the picture. Paradoxes like this convince some people that you can't travel in time, so you can't travel faster than the speed of light. But it isn't as clear-cut as it seems.